Welcome back to my channel, everyone. Here again doing another Farming Simulator 19 video, just covering some more details I've discovered on the new Precision Farming DLC. I apologize that I missed this before and it's not in my previous video, so I'm doing this video for you today, guys, and hopefully I can give you a little bit more information. I have been playing around with it, I've been testing it and found this out for myself, so just thought I'd put this in the video to show you what the go is. First thing is, I'll just retest my field, get my soil samples again. Which you can see how this is done in my other videos if you like, but yeah, again, apologies for missing these little details. So I'll just take this first one here, guys, and I'll just keep going till I get my whole field done. So it is a 25 meter radius for the soil sample test. Just send those off, we'll pack that up, wait for the results to come back, which won't take long. Okay, so we'll just jump in, pH is okay, it's a little low, so we can fix that. We just jump in here, but this is what I was talking about, guys. The things I did miss is with your fertilizing and your liming, so your nitrogen and pH levels, you can set the gear to automatic, or you can actually manually adjust it, like the flow. I don't know if it's the flow rate, or I guess it would relate to that as well, but you can adjust the amount you put onto the ground going off your grid on your map there. And by doing that, you just held L1, and in the L1 you see the option pop up to push right, I was about to say left because I don't know my left from my right. bear with me, guys, I'll get there. So you push right on your directional pad on your controller, and again, I'm on PS5, so yeah, right on your directional pad on your controller, and it actually turns on and off the automatic application rate. So you can do this manually yourself and actually control the flow rate. So what you do is you turn it off and it'll actually say activate automatic application rate. Well, that means that the application rate is now not automatic. I can manually adjust it. And to manually adjust that, you still push down on your L1 trigger, and in the window there you can see under open cover it says change application rate. So to do that, you hold L1 and move your right stick left and right, and in the bar at the bottom where it says pH value lime application, you can see The little red line lets me know where my pH level is at, and the little flag tells me where it should be for this part of the field that I'm on. So by moving my right stick, as you can see, the values go up. Now I can't applicate the lime or the fertilizer or slurry, manure, whatever. You can't go under, but you can go way over, as you can see. So it goes from that dark olive green to a good green to sort of right where we want it. But then you can keep going and you can over applicate any of your stuff. So you can put way too much on there, so your flow rate goes right up, and yeah, it's, and then that'll just put your pH level way out, or your nitrogen level way out. So, and that will potentially affect your yield. So what I found is you just move it enough to get it to that dark green color. If you can see, you got the olive green, a brighter green, that's good too. So that's where you want it, that darkish bright green. That says that's perfect for this part of the field. So you turn on your lime spreader. You do have to watch it because the soil does change. And then as you see, as I'm applying it to the field, on the map, on my mini map, it's going that same color green to say that my pH level is spot on for that spot on the field. We can continue on. There's that bit. So we'll turn around, we'll just finish this field, and I'll just show you that you can do it. The automatic rate does work well too for your first go, but it'll only let you do to a certain level. You can't finely tune it like I can now. So that flow rate says I'm perfect there as well. So I can just run this back here like so. So now you have to keep watching that bar up there, the pH level lime application bar, because it does change when you get to a different colored soil there. It'll either drop or raise, but like that, as you saw it drop. I didn't get a chance to, so I can come back now. So that's been over, it's a little bit over on my pH, so it's okay. It's not ideal, but it could be worse. I might be able to sort that out with my fertilizer, maybe the nitrogen. So then you come to this part of the field, and as you can see, it's a bit of both, so I have to adjust it now as I go. So see, that's now saying my flow rate is way too high for where I am on the field. So L1 again, guys, and on my right stick I can just adjust it to now where it's perfectly in the green, and I can just drive along till I get to where the soil changes there. Then I can adjust that out to the green again. I can just keep going a little bit further. It may change again, it may not. Yep, it has. So then I can drop my lime flow rate, and this is just getting my pH balance perfect on my field. So on your first application for your new fields and that, I guess you can run it on automatic, set your worker off, and then come over it the second time by yourself and adjust it just to fix it up to get your field perfect the way you want it, because this all maximizes your yield. So as you can see again, I need to adjust it. My flow rate's too high, so I'll just turn that down to where I want it. And we start going again. On the bigger fields, this might take heaps longer to do, but again, you don't have to have this DLC on if you don't want to. It says just adds another aspect to the game. And there we have it. So that should be perfect for the types of soil that I have. So I'll just drive back onto the field. Okay, so we'll check in here. So my pH level, we'll go to soil type. So the soil type was loam soil and sandy loam. So for that, the pH level is spot on, because I'm pretty sure for the loam soil you need it to be at 6.5 mark, and for the sandy loam needs to be at the 6.5. Could be wrong, I'll go check the values later. It does tell you in the information, which I might go check now actually for you. So there it is. So there it is, guys. Sorry about the interruption. Little fella asked me for a bit of cheese. So there's your pH levels for your soils, guys. So for loamy sand soil you need 6% pH, for sandy loam you need 6.5, for loam you need 6.75, and for silty clay you need 7. So when we go back here, I had loam and sandy loam. So my pH level, so for my loam soil I'm up in the 6.75, which is where I wanted to be, and for my sandy loam soil I'm on the 6.5. so my pH is now perfect for that soil. So we'll just put the lime spreader away here, guys, and we'll get the fertilizer out, and we can do the same with the fertilizers. So I'll do a line of slurry just to show you that it does work with all those as well. I've got the class here with the slurry spreader on it. So you can adjust all your fertilizers and limes to get this to work. We'll just deactivate automatic and pop out on the field here. As you can see, it's saying I need a lot more, so we'll adjust that right up to probably there. We'll turn that on. We'll get that spreading. Keep adjusting it when we need to. So as you can see, you can do it with your slurry, your manure and all that. So I'll just go back over here. I was just going to catch this side of the field, but my first pass was perfect, but I just didn't get it right on the edge, so that's okay. It's just testing anyway, it's not my actual proper farm, it's just to give you guys an idea of how this stuff can work. So that's with the slurry, guys. As you can see, I've got a nice green strip perfectly down the side of the field. And we'll just go to the solid fertilizer, which is just your fertilizer you buy from the silos or in pallets from the shop. So that's fine. and I'll just go up to 36 meter spread. Then we go on to this bit. Again, okay, that says it's perfectly adjusted there, so we'll start with that. Yep, nice. We'll just keep going, yep. So that's on automatic, so you can see how that's just automatically adjusting my spread there. Or that part of the field. So then I'll change the width down to 24. So I'll come here and I'll turn off my automatic, and I can do this strip manually. Okay, so I need a lot of fertilizer there. As she says, you know, my mineral fertilizer. So I'll just adjust that all the way up till it's green where I want it. Turn it on. And we will get fertilizing. So that's staying green where I want it to. It's just got to adjust it here and there when you need to. As you can see, my field is going green just like I wanted it to. Now that it's on manual, I can actually come back and check it there if I want. That's perfectly done for how I want it. So you can leave it automatic, or if you want to finer tune your pH level and your nitrogen, you can turn it to manual like I showed you. And another question I've seen get brought up is about what vehicles this soil sampler will attach to, and I'll show you that in a second. But getting back to the field, as you can see, my pH level for that bit of sandy loam soil on the edge of my field is exactly at 6.5, as you can see in the field info at the bottom, which is perfect. Nitrogen is 160 kilograms per hectare. So there, so you can change into the different soils. So the loam soil needed a bit more, so it's got 180 to 2. Oh, excuse me. Oh, I just had a cuppa there earlier, and now I'm bringing up a bit of indigestion. Sorry about that, guys. Apologies. So as you can see, like I was saying, the pH level is basically perfect where I want it. Little bit high there, not by much, but still a bit. So that'll affect my yield a tiny bit, but I don't think it's going to be too much. And then my nitrogen is sitting perfect. So if you come in here, you go to your precision farming, you can see there that my pH level is pretty much spot on across my field. And then my nitrogen level is pretty good as well. It's between 160 to 200 kilograms a hectare, depending on what your soil is. But yeah, just thought I'd touch on that, guys, because yeah, I did discover that you can do it manually and automatically. It's up to you how you want to do it. I mean, automatically is probably the easiest way to go. But yeah, if you just want to bring that little bit of extra realism or whatever into your precision farming, then you can turn it all off onto manual by, again, I'll just go over it. You just jump in whatever tractor vehicle you've got with your spreader on it. You click your L1 and then you hit right on your direction pad, and you can activate or deactivate automatic application. Totally up to you how you want to use it. Just thought I'd point that out, guys, just so you can tune your gameplay to how you like to do it. Now getting back on to these guys, the soil samplers, I've had a few questions saying that what vehicles do they hook up to, and is it only the gator they go on? And the answer is no. They go on any vehicle with a 3-point hitch. So I'll just drop this one off the gator and move the gator out of the way. And Yeah, there's some. I mean, you wouldn't want to, but there are some funny things you can hook this up to. So, for one, if you're doing a forestry gameplay and you want to bring precision farming in to replant your tree fields for harvesting again, you've got a tree planter, so you could get this or any forestry bit of gear with, as you can see, it has 3-point link there on the back. This is just the Trek 600 stump grinder lizard thing. It's under forestry, but it has a 3-point link on the back, so you could use this to do it. So you can just hook that up like so, you can unfold it, you can lower it, and boom, take your samples if you like. Completely up to you. Don't have to, but that's just an option. Also, we'll just fold that back up, and drop that off there, move this out of the way, smash into my gator. I'll just park that there. Another example, guys, is you can drop this. Yes, I'm going to attach this to a slurry tank, because a lot of these slurry tanks do have a 3-point link on the back to hook up various fertilizer injectors and disc harrows and fertilizer spreaders and stuff. But as you can see, it will pick up the soil sampler, so you can even drive around like this and do your soil sampling. You can unfold it, do it all, everything, even on the back of a slurry tank. Why you'd want to do it that way, I don't know, but it's an option if you don't want to drop your whole trailer off and you want to fertilize your field with your slurry. You can go around, do your samples, drop it off, drop your sample, a soil sampler off, then pick up whatever slurry spreader attachment you have on there and do a quick change without dropping the trailer. You can even put it on this guy, which is a little lizard telehandler. It has an option to put a 3-point link on the back, which is what I have done. So yeah, you can run around with this as well, guys, just like so. There you go. So yeah, any vehicle basically with a 3-point link, front or back, you can pick up the soil sampler. So if you did want it on the front of a tractor, just jump out of the telehandler, so you just jump in the case. Most tractors that you can get come with a front and rear 3-point link, or you can add one in the options menu. But you can, oops, sorry guys, line that up properly, so you can pick that up. So technically you could drive along with the sampler on the front, do your soil samples, wait a couple of minutes once you send them off, get them back, and have your fertilizer on the back, and just boom, straight into laying your nitrogen down or your fertilizer, getting it spot on. And you don't even have to change equipment, you just do it all from the one bit of gear. Same with your limer, you could put the sampler on the tractor on the front of your limer and then take your samples and go straight into doing your pH levels, guys. So just thought I'd touch on that as well. So you can attach them to anything with a 3-point link. What I am going to do now as well is I'm going to plant my field out with some sunflowers. Doesn't matter, any crop would work. I just pick sunflowers because what I want to show off, to me, shows up better in the sunflowers. If this is going to turn properly for me, for some reason didn't want to turn. So we'll just unfold this. once I plant this, I'll cut the video, I'll fast forward the time, I'll come back with a field with a crop grown in it, either ready to harvest or into first or second stage of growth. And I'll show you some more things that I discovered. Hopefully they help you out. So just depends on your play style, really. So when I get onto that part, I'll explain and then show you what the go is. I'll just finish planting my field. And again, all this is so you can precisely make your fields as best you can get them, and then in return that should boost the yield you get off your field, which in turn is then going to make you more profit. So it's not a bad idea. I get the idea and the concept behind the DLC, and I'm pretty sure it's in real life too, so I get the idea of it. You take your soil samples, you get your soil all prepared and ready to go, you get the levels right for whatever crop that you're going to put into the soil types that you have, and that should maximize your yield on the farm, and then in turn that is going to get you a better yield from that crop, and then in turn for you as a farmer, I guess, get you more profit because you now have more product to sell, so, and probably a better product to sell. It's a really cool idea. As far as I know and what I've heard, it is actually spearheaded by John Deere in real life. They've been helping in the development of this. That's really cool. Again, don't quote me on that, it's just what I've heard. Pretty sure it's true. I didn't go fact checking or anything like that. I mean, you can probably Google it or whatever, but I'm pretty sure John Deere is spearheading the project, or is a big player in the project. That's really cool. I'll just finish off this bit of planting on this side of the field, guys, and I'll stop it there. I'll fast forward time. I'll come back in with a crop on the field, and then I'll show you some of the other things I found out that I was talking about. Really, they're only minor things, but it's the way some people have their settings in the game and the way they play, this might help them out, so that's why I thought I'd do it. So I'll be right back, guys, just bear with me for a sec, I'll fast forward time and we'll jump back in. Okay, and I'm back, and for those who play with crop destruction on, which is what I have turned on at the moment, I have seen people asking, can, if I'm on a new game, or I'm on a game that I'm halfway through and I buy a new field, I extend my farm, the field has already a product in it and I'd like to fertilize it and get it going again, can I drive the gator out onto my field with the soil sampler on it, take a soil sample, will it destroy my crops? And the answer for the gator that come in the DLC is no, it does not destroy your crops. So you can drive out onto your field, it's like so, lower that down, take your sample, in the middle of the field, and you can drive off, and you do not destroy your crops in this gator. That's pretty cool. However, it will destroy your crops if you use a tractor. So if I just jump in the case here, the nice big wide tires on it, that's not the tractor. What am I doing? I want the case, thank you. Pick that up, go say down this end to do a sample. Drive in, boom, big wide tires, nut takes out the crop, can't do it like that. So that works just the same as without the DLC. That's fine, it's expected. So you will have to get a tractor like I have, if you're going to use a tractor and not the gator. Just park the case here out of the way. And I just went with this big guy because it is modded, it's the big Fent 1000 series, and as you can see it's got the dual row crop skinny tires on it. So that's what you'll need on your tractor, whether that's got duals or whether it's single row crops or whatever, but you need the skinny tires on there. And you can this tractor's a bit of overkill for the size of the sampler, but it's just to prove a point. But you now can drive out into your field with your tractor like so. Pop the sampler down, take your sample. Boom, sample's done. Send it off. Fold that up, lift it up, and drive right on out of your field without destroying your crops, guys. So yeah, it's just the same as in the base game. If you've got crop destruction turned on, you will need the skinnier row crop tires, just like so. Whether you do the duals or you do the singles, it's up to you. But I just thought I'd point that out. I'd probably just stick to using the gator, really, because that is a pretty cool bit of kit. But like I said, again, up to you how you run your farm. If you didn't have a crop in there, that's fine. You could use any vehicle with a 3-point link to go and take your samples before you, after you buy it. Sorry, not before, because you have to own the land to do any work on it. But yeah. So, but if you don't have the money to set up the tractor like that, or any tractor like that, then that's probably the cheaper alternative, is just to get the gator, whack it on there, head out to your field. So yeah, they're just a few of the questions or things I've seen. I just thought I'd try and answer them in here. So first one is yes, you can turn automatic off and run it manually and adjust it yourself if you like. Completely up to you. If you want to get that perfect pH and nitrogen levels up to their 6.5 or 7 or whatever, depending on the type of soil you've got. No, the gator will not destroy your crops with the soiler sampler on the back. That's saying I need more nitrogen, so I could get ready to run another. I mean, that's ready to harvest, but so that must have dropped overnight. So that's something. Oh, there it's saying it's perfect, but anyway, man, that's a bit weird. Okay. There it's saying my nitrogen, oh no, now it's saying it's good, now it's bad. Must be bad just in that corner there. Further out says it's perfect, good, bad. It's flicking around in there. Anyway, yeah, it's just curious. Yeah, it's a bit weird, but yeah, just they're the questions I wanted to answer, guys. So Again, sorry, just went off track there, just rambling about the field. Sorry, I lost track of where I am, but yeah, so any tractors, even with these small ones with the big tires, you can't drive on your crops with crop destruction turned on to take your sample. It will destroy the crops. I mean, it doesn't matter if you buy a new field and you don't want the crop that's in it, then, you know, just destroy it or whatever, that's fine. Also, I did find out if you were to buy a new field, you didn't want the crop, you can jump in that sort of setup and cultivate the field in, cultivate the crop into the ground, and it does give you a slight nitrogen boost to your soil, like it did in the base game where you'd cultivate it in and it'd give you a fertilizing state. So it would give you that one fertilizing state in the base game without the precision farming. It looks like this still does it. I've did it in testing the other day. You can try that out for yourself, but it does work. So if you buy a new field and say it's got like sunflowers in it here, for example, and you cultivate them in before you do anything else to your field, it will give you a lighter ready orange scale in your nitrogen level because you've cultivated that in, and it does give you a bit of a fertilizing state. So that's really cool. So that's another way of saving a bit of fertilizing money on your field. But then again, if you want the crop harvested out and then plant your own, that's fine. Just thought I'd point that out, guys, but it does actually work and does change the color on your live map. My pH level, nitrogen's okay according to my map, so I can't really demonstrate that right now. But yeah, by all means, have a play around with it, guys, because it does work. And yeah, I might wrap that video up here, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope the information I gave out has helped you. I hope I was clear about what I was telling you guys. I found this out just by testing myself and playing on my own little personal farm that I have on a save game, and I'm enjoying it. I'm liking this new precision farming, but you may not. If you download it and you don't like it, then yeah, just either turn it off in your mods list or just uninstall it. Completely up to you. But yeah, so hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, guys, give me a thumbs up, smash that like button for me. If you haven't yet done so, please subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate it. You're all legends for watching my stuff. And like always, until next time, guys, I'll catch you later.